Merci,
I'm honored to have the opportunity to speak to you here at the World Policy Conference. And I think it's a really timely topic. Many of you might have on the way over to Marrakech picked up the latest issue of The Economist. And their cover story actually asked, is social media undermining democracy? And this is really remarkable how our discourse, our discussion about the internet has really changed in the past years. I want to start with a quote from Hillary Clinton, your Secretary of State, and she said, the Internet has become the public space of the 21st century, the world's town square, classroom, marketplace, coffee house, and nightclub. We all are shaped by what happens there. All 2 billion of us and counting. She said that in May 2011, and really captured a very optimistic mood about the internet at that time. It was a place where people could, the place was seen as a place where people can globally connect, where they can share ideas, and where they can actually shape the world for better. And now fast forward to the end of 2016, and Hillary Clinton coming from an upset defeat in the U.S. presidential election, and she calls the internet as become
Elle a dit que l'Internet a dit maintenant que les fake news sont devenues une pandémie.
The presidential election.
Et donc
but the fake news discussion is not just about the United States.
Mais les fake news, en fait, n'affectent pas
are
seulement
real,
les États-Unis, et les conséquences sont réelles
around
et peuvent être perçues de par le monde.
Topic,
donc c'est un sujet pour la World
Brexit,
Policy
course,
Conference. Alors on a connu aussi le
Brexit, the
Brexit
campaign,
et
lots
dans la
of fake news like this one,
Brexit, il y a eu beaucoup de fake news telles que celle-ci qui ont été partagées et décimées.
The latest stories, the New York Times covered this. This is from The Guardian, mentioning that in Myanmar, fake images and also fake news are used to instigate violence against the Rohingya Muslim minority. And also a topic we talked about this morning at the conference on the independence vote in Catalonia, and also in the context of the Catalonian discussion.
There was lots of stress.
Of fake news, a lot of fake news, for example, about fake incidents of police brutality. I mean, there was some incidents with the police, but also lots of made-up stories that were shared widely on the internet.
Qui ont été partagées sur internet.
We have heard the term a lot. I think it's
donc on a beaucoup entendu ce terme.
To take a moment and reflect what
il est important
term
de prendre un moment et de réfléchir à ce que ce terme fake news
found,
signifie vraiment.
When we look further into it, that the term is widely
car
used.
Le,
on the
le
left,
terme est
you see,
largement utilisé et sur la gauche, vous pouvez voir que le fake news est devenu un terme politique qui est utilisé par exemple par le président Trump pour miner en fait les médias.
Et
parfois, on crée des nouvelles mais sous forme de satire, mais les fake news peuvent également être dues à un journalisme qui laisse à discerner, car les journalistes font commettent des erreurs, ce qui peut déboucher sur des fake news. Mais on est plus préoccupé par ce qui est écrit sur la droite et qui est souligné en rouge, c'est que c'est de disséminer des informations, des fausses informations de façon intentionnelle.
To give it a different spin and to drive an agenda. And that's really when you look at all these cases that are cited, if you look at the US presidential campaign, if you look at the Brexit campaign, if you look at Catalonia, you'll actually find that spreading fake news are not just incidents on the internet, they're usually part of campaigns.
They're strategies
for political mobilization in all of these cases. And I would argue here that we should understand really the problem of fake news as they are being used as a strategy for political mobilization.
mobilisation. Stratégie en vue de la mobilisation politique.
And you can rightly ask, and
vous
we should rightly ask ourselves, what's actually new about this? What's actually new about fake news? And here's an example from medieval Europe, spreading fake news. This is fake news about Jews killing Christian babies and blood libel. And this is an image that depicts that, that was used to incite violence and pogroms against Jewish people.
Fake news have been around throughout history, so what's really new about them?
And this brings us, of course, to what we have been talking about here at the panel today, the Internet revolution, the digital revolution,
the spread of the Internet, et à la dissémination de l'Internet et des médias sociaux qui nous offrent à tous la capacité non seulement de produire des nouvelles, mais également de les partager, de les distribuer. Deux fonctions en fait, qui étaient dédiées à la radio, à la télévision, à la presse, etc.
Donc maintenant, on peut créer ces nouvelles et ces organisations médiatiques ont perdu cette fonction. Who's connected to the internet, who has the ability to use Facebook, who has a smartphone to take pictures, can create stories, and can share them on the internet, and can also distribute new stories to friends and networks. That's what's really new. And at the same time, we see that the established media is in a crisis, not only in a crisis of revenue, as Stephen earlier mentioned, declining revenue, but also that there's a lot of distrust in established news media around the world. We can see that it's not the same everywhere. So some countries there's so much more trust in news media. In Germany, also, there's another slide next. It's still quite high. There are other countries where it's much lower. This is also a problem in the US, where the high penetration of social media, the loss of use of social media, combined with the distrust in the established regroupé avec la méfiance dans les médias a mené vraiment à ce problème de prolifération de fake news. So let's take a look at Germany. Donc, also in Germany, and this is coming now from our own data, this is from a survey we did right after the German election.
Suite à une étude ou un sondage que l'on a fait après l'élection en Allemagne,
there is distrust in the media, but there's a particular group that has very high distrust in Allemagne,
mais il y a surtout un groupe.
Those are the AfD voters. AfD is the alternative for Germany. It's this new party, staunchly anti-immigrant, and that had been upset, surprise success in the German election, getting more than 12% of the national vote, getting into parliament. And you will see that they have very high numbers among AfD voters who distrust media, and they are also the group that is most likely to believe fake news, and that is most active in sharing fake news. And we would therefore also argue that in Germany, fake news were mostly used in the context of the election campaign as a political strategy to mobilize AfD voters. And you will probably ask yourselves what, and we are asking ourselves also about, you know, what should we do about it? Do we need regulation?
Est-ce qu'on ne devrait pas développer une réglementation? Quelle est la responsabilité déontologique des entreprises de charger des médias sociaux?
Alors, il y a trois points
qui sont basés sur les données que l'on pourrait élaborer davantage dans notre au débat. La colonne rouge, dans la colonne rouge, vous pouvez voir donc toutes les fake news, et en vert, c'est un cas spécial, c'est la, ce sont les nouvelles en fait qui ont corrigé ces fake news. Mais il y a beaucoup d'entités médiatiques qui essaient de maintenant de corriger les nouvelles, ce qu'on appelle le debunk, et l'effet n'est pas aussi grand que les fake news qui attirent davantage d'attention. Ça, c'est le premier point. Le deuxième point, c'est que beaucoup de fake news proviennent de ce que j'appelle un journalisme amateur.
So here's another story that came up in the context of the German election campaign.
where there was an incident where bottles were thrown at the German police, and the initial press release talked about a gathering of 1,000 young people, and there were bottles were thrown at the police. And a media report turned these 1,000 young people into 1,000 rioters, and then fake news stories appeared that were talking about 1,000 young migrant rioters that were throwing bottles at the police. And see, that's what we see consistently when there's ambiguous reporting, if there's poor reporting or poor press release, and that this is often taken advantage of to put a new spin on it and use that spin for political purposes. Here, again, to put blame against and finally, what we see, what really doesn't work that well, and our data shows this too, is the fabrication of news. If you completely make stuff up, and the most effective way to stop that is if organizations immediately put out counter-narratives on social media. So this was a fake news story. That apparently a German minister in a big German state had said the police should not talk about migrant criminality.
La police ne devrait pas parler des migrants et de la criminalité.
When this news appeared, immediately his office put out a statement that he never said that this is not true, that this is fake. You see that his debunking story was very widely shared and let that the fake news story was completely ineffective. So it's also really important that we very quickly react fake news stories come up. Now, I would like to end it here. Thank you for your attention.
Stéphane, thank you very, very much.